Hi, my name is Juan Brilla and I'm the head of the WHO European Office for Prevention and Control of Noncommunicable Diseases. It's really a pleasure to be with you today. Physical inactivity, as you know, is one of the main risk factors for noncommunicable diseases and also very important in terms of overall quality of life and particularly loss of quality of life, notably in the last 10 years during our life course. So it's really very important that we address physical inactivity. This risk factor, it must be recognized, acknowledged, and addressed through the health sector and with the support of the health sector, not only, of course, in the context of a comprehensive approach and with other stakeholders. It's very important that the health sector plays its role, mainly at primary healthcare level. It needs to be done in a similar way to how we address other behavioral and biological risk factors. Probably we've been doing more in the area of tobacco use, overweight and obesity, even alcohol consumption, high blood pressure, and to a large extent, sometimes physical inactivity or addressing physical activity and its promotion becomes a bit of the forgotten element. So we need to overcome that. The promotion of physical activity through the health sector, as I said, is a key component of the physical activity strategy for the WHO European region, and it's also part of the global physical activity action plan. It is indeed an effective and efficient way to increase physical activity of the populations with the support of healthcare professionals, because they in general reach a large proportion of this population and many times those who are really more in need. It can have benefits for the healthcare system as a whole, a lot of savings, early identification of problems, reducing the demand placed on primary care services to really go more into the area of treating chronic conditions in a more sophisticated and more expensive way. So WHO definitely, we call for every health professional to be trained and how to perform brief assessment and brief counseling on physical activity alongside other NCD risk factors and also understanding sedentary behavior so that they are equipped to promote active and healthy lifestyles. So we believe that more preparation, more training is also needed in this context. Health professionals need to know how much more physical activity their patients need to engage with to protect their health, to achieve the full and the entirety of the benefits which are available, and to be able to provide indeed practical advice on how to include more activity as part of the individuals, of the every citizen in terms of their daily life. Also, referrals of patients to certified exercise professionals or others that can engage with the promotion of physical activity is an important and key tool that needs to be understood and used potentially in a more systematized way. So the role of primary care also in referral as well in terms of physical activity, exercise is important. Training, as I said, in this area needs to be provided ideally in an undergraduate fashion to sensitize to the topic, but also via programs on a postgraduate way, in a postgraduated fashion, and of course delivered to higher education institutions, the renowned ones with a reputation in these areas of health promotion, physical activity, and in dealing with chronic non-communicable diseases. Thank you very much for the opportunity, and it's been a pleasure to be with you today and wish all of luck, and I hope that we can all engage in promoting physical activity through primary health care and to the context of health systems. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Sarah Hansen and I'm a lecturer in health sciences. I'm based at the University of East Anglia in the UK. And we recognise how vitally important it is to have physical activity on the curriculum here. We've also introduced this beautiful, on our beautiful campus, walking routes as part of our active campus, which has been really appreciated by staff and students. And so why is this important? Well, we know that one in four adults globally are not physically active enough to benefit their health, and that's about 80% of adolescents. And it's really vitally important because we know that this is a known determinant for cancer, diabetes, coronary heart disease, cardiovascular disease, and a host of other diseases. On top of that, we have health inequalities, which are one of the most pernicious issues of our time. And that means that people who you want to have this benefit to their health by being more physically active may not have access to interventions such as walking groups or gyms, for example. So here at UEA, we're doing all we can to help support our health professionals by training them in the importance of physical activity and then giving them the skills to support their patients of the future in the behaviour changes that they might need.